Hi folks, it's Mike Murphy, and today's quick tip is an Adobe After Effects CC 2023. And in this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to use the grid effect to make a simple background. I'll show you how to change the background colors, the grid line colors, add some texture, a little movement, and a little bonus tip. So this was the inspiration for this tutorial. We are going to be creating this grid background paper from scratch in After Effects. So first, create a new composition. Composition, new composition. 1920 by 1080 pixels, 10 seconds in duration. We'll call it grid. Click OK. Next, create a new solid layer. To do so, you can right click or control click in the layers panel, go to new solid, or come up to the top menu, go to layer, new, solid, or use the keyboard shortcut command or control Y. I'll name it grid solid. I'll click make comp size. For the background color, I'm going to use this light gray, E6, 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 then click OK, OK. Now it's time to add the grid effect. If you don't see effects and presets, just go to the window menu and select effects and presets. In the search field, type out grid, G-R-I-D. It'll be under the generate category. Click, you can drag it right onto the layer, or you can just drag it right onto the comp window, and now you have yourself a grid. Before we customize the grid, I just want to point out, when you add the grid effect, you'll see the background color of the solid is removed. That blue that you're seeing, that's just the blue from the composition settings, so that's not going to render out in the final video. If I click the transparency grid, you can see that's a transparent background grid. We'll address the background in just a little bit. So with the solid layer selected, we'll go up to the effect controls and customize the grid. The first thing I'll do is change size from corner point to width and height sliders. For the width, I'm going to enter in a value of 42. For the height, I'm going to enter in 38. And for the border, I'm going to enter 3. To change the color of the grid lines, you're going to use the color property in the grid effect. So just click on the color swatch and pick a new color, or you can use the eyedropper tool and select a new color. And to add a solid color background below the grid lines, one way we can do so is just to create a new solid. So I'll just right click or control click in the layers panel, go to new solid, I'll go to make comp size, I'll call this BG for background, I'll drag it below the grid. Now the grid's kind of hard to see, so I'll select the solid layer, go to the color property, and I'll change it to a little darker gray, so B9, B9, B9. We have a replica of what we were originally trying to create. And to give it a little texture, I'll just drag on this crumpled paper texture that I downloaded for free. I'll just drag it in between the grid and the background layer. And now I've got a little texture. And if I want to back it off a little bit, maybe it's a little too strong, I'll tap T for opacity and just drag down the opacity of that slider. And now we've got a pretty cool grid, which will make a nice background for a scrapbook or kind of a cutout looking animation. You can always change this background color solid if you want to change the color behind the grid, but it's going to layer solid settings and just changing the color for that solid. Want to add a little movement to the grid? Drag the playhead to the beginning of the timeline. Select the solid layer. Go up to the anchor property, click the stopwatch to add a keyframe, and click on this little anchor center point. You'll see this grid go in the middle here. I'm just going to click. I'll drag the playhead forward in time. And I'm just going to move that little point. You can move it in any direction you want. I'm just going to move it a little bit. I'll drag the playhead back to the beginning. I'll tap the spacebar to preview. And now my grid's moving a little bit. And a bonus tip for the minimalists. If you want to do everything all on one solid layer, go up to the effects and presets and search for solid composite. Drag it onto the solid layer. And now you have a color control for the background, so I can click on this eyedropper tool and select a new background color, and I'll use the color property under the grid effect to change the grid color. And of course, if you want to add some texture, you can just add it right on top of the solid layer. And that is how to use the grid effect in Adobe After Effects CC 2022. My name is Mike Murphy. Cheers.